So Marty, one of the issues is the tactile feedback that you give up, obviously, in the coronaries, and maybe it's less of an issue in the peripheral vascular territory. But what do people think about that?
It's a very good question. I have to say that, and I argue with people, I think people make a little bit too much of this tactile feedback. I think when you're at the end of a guide wire, a floppy tip guide wire, you don't feel much of anything. It's more visually seeing the movement of the guide wire that you somehow interpret that as being tactile. I think it's much, much more visual feedback than it is tactile. So I don't know that you lose very much. I think what you gain is the precision of control. And I think that over time...
What I also believe about tactile is that I think a lot of tactile is actually visual.
Yeah,
you actually,
exactly.
You know, when you see a wire hit something on fluoro.
Yeah, when we work with fellows and when they don't move the wire well, you see that before them, even that they don't know they don't move
the
wire.
Right, I was just about to say that. We experience that every day when you see the fellows and you know exactly what they should be doing and you don't have your hands on the wire.
What are your point, Marty, about control and ergonomics? Just from doing, when we operate on tibials or if we do microsurgery, which I did in the lab for a while, it's very much about, there is no tactile feedback at all. It's all visual. And so it's all about illumination and magnification and getting your arms resting on a solid surface so that you can use the incredible control that you have in your hand rather than your arm muscles. So these are really sort of microsurgical principles, but I think they're applicable to some of these more delicate and nuanced endovascular procedures.